Hi guys, Duke of the Bum. Welcome back to more or less play Sonic Megamix. I have to say, so far this looks an awful lot like the Marble Zone. The enemies are slightly differently colored. Man, that's gonna be the death of me, I just know it. I wanna friggin' homie attack my way to my eventual destruction. Yeah, the caterpillars are green. At least that one was. The bees are... they look about the same. Dang it. I didn't want the lightning shield. I like being able to do the ring dash more than I like being able to attract rings. So yeah, I was supposed to be able to ring dash my way right up there. Now I have to ride that cylinder thing. And the bats are green. And that thing I just killed, or the bats were red, that thing I just killed was green. And that thing's not supposed to show up until, Spring Yard Zone. Or whatever this game's equivalent of the Spring Yard Zone is. I have to say, this is a pretty impressive ROM hack overall. It'd be nice if the enemies were more than just palette swaps, though. I don't know, maybe it'll introduce some new enemies later in the game. So just a reminder, this is absolutely new to me. I have never played what's called the Dark Fortress Zone. Never played it in my life. So far, pretty impressed. Level design's pretty good. Nice and fast. It's a robotic box there. Yeah, so far this is making much more frequent use of the Robotnik boxes than I've seen any Sonic game do before. Which again, I think it's only Sonic and Knuckles that has them. I thought maybe they were in Sonic CD, but now that I think of it, I don't really remember them there either. Oh, and I got crushed. Honestly, they might be in Sonic 3, because I've never really... I mean, I've played that game, and I've beaten it, but, like, about a hundredth as much as I've beaten all the other Sonic games for the Genesis. I never had Sonic 3 when I was a kid. I didn't really play it until years later on the emulator. I played Sonic 1 and 2 as a kid, and Sonic and Knuckles. I just kind of skipped 3 for some reason. Which is good, because of the 16-bit Sonic games, not counting Sonic 3D Blast, it's really the worst one. And, you know, obviously, Sonic 3D Blast doesn't count. And, I mean, Sonic 3 is still kind of enjoyable, but it just doesn't hold a candle to Sonic 1, Sonic 2, and Sonic & Knuckles. Which reminds me, I got in a discussion with someone in a stream earlier. Well, not really a discussion, but, you know, I stated my opinion that Sonic 1 is the easiest Sonic game, or at least the original, the easiest, you know, classic Sonic game, and he thought I was crazy. How the hell do I get out of here? I mean, I don't know, maybe it's just, oh, I see. That's a writable thing. Maybe it's just because I played it so much. I mean, I played the shit out of Sonic 1, but, yeah, I mean, I just find Sonic 1 is probably... well, I don't know. Really, I rate it and Sonic 2 at about the same. I mean, I think Sonic CD is the hardest of the original Sonic games. Damn it, I really wanted those rings. How do I get them without dying? There we go. But yeah, Sonic 2 is pretty easy too, though. Yeah, I'd say I'd probably have to rate Sonic 2 as being easier than Sonic 1, now that I really think about it. Because Sonic 1 has the Labyrinth Zone, which on its own is pretty tough. Sonic 2, there's really no single part of Sonic 2 that's overly challenging. I mean, the last boss, I think the last boss of Sonic 2 is harder than the last boss of Sonic 1, which is probably partially what's coloring my opinion. I'm probably missing so much shit. I'm not even really paying that much attention. which, you know, is a hallmark of a good Sonic game. You shouldn't have to pay attention. Or not that much attention, anyway. I mean, you should just be able to, you know, let your muscle memory take over. Or, if not muscle memory, then just, you know, pure physical reflexes. I have to say, I'm impressed so far. I like how every act of the zones has different music. Sonic and Knuckles did the same thing. They used slightly, or different variations on themes anyway. But in this game, the music from one act to another is just completely different. And it's not bad so far. I don't know what this is, but if it's original, then it's not bad. For, you know, original Sonic music. I don't like the fact that they included the little weird vocal samples from Sonic 3 in the theme for the Speed Shoes music. That's one of the things that I really don't like that much about Sonic 3, is the music. Probably has the worst music of the series, honestly. I mean, what do you expect when friggin' Michael Jackson helped work on the soundtrack? Oh boy, wow. Oh my god. This is just, this is pretty intense. I have to say, I'm really, damn it, I'm really digging the level design. It's like, I don't know, it's just, it flows so well. Wonder if there are any secret passages I'm missing. I mean, sometimes I'm getting blown through secret passages without even really realizing it. What was that? Invincibility? Cool. I'll take that. I was able to do the first zone, or the entire first zone in a single video, but I'm probably not going to be able to do that in the future, because these levels already feel like they're getting kind of long, and of course, you know, I don't know what to expect in any of them, so I might have to split up zones into a couple videos. I don't know if I should. Aw, that was bullshit. I hit that caterpillar right in the head. I punched him in the mouth. I don't know whether I should just end the video, like now that it's like a good stopping point, or if I should go on ahead and continue to the next act and just hope for the best. I mean, if I can beat it before the 11-minute mark, then great, but if not, then, you know, it's going to be kind of an awkward transition. I use the ring dash and it screws me almost every single time. Now this is some cool music. I have to say, I'm really impressed with the amount of work that went into this video, or this game, rather. I mean, you know, this is obviously, you know, the result of, you know, a deep love and respect for the Sonic series. Which, you know, it's kind of depressing that technically this is, like, totally illegal. And, you know, Sonic or Sega could probably shut the whole project down if they wanted to. Like Square did with the Chrono Trigger fan remake. I'm surprised they haven't gotten, like, a cease and desist letter yet or something. And it's probably coming. Which is sad. I mean, I think that fan games like this should be able to, you know, coexist peacefully with the original IP. I mean, it's not like this is hurting Sega's sales in any way. I mean, it might harm their image because people realize that, hey, this game that some fans made is better than any Sonic game that Sega officially released in the past 10 years. Or the Sonic team made in the past 10 years, anyway. I don't know. I think I already like this game better than Sonic Rush. I mean, how could I not? It's original 16-bit Sonic-y goodness. Whoa, I was walking right through that wall. I mean, obviously, you know, you can walk through the wall, but I was, like, in front of it instead of behind it. See? That's weird. In front? Still in front. Behind. Okay, so it's not 100% glitch-free, but, you know, ow! Who's counting glitches? I mean, besides me, of course. Getting kind of close to the 11-minute mark here. I'm probably going to have to pause it and then do the boss in the next video. So yeah, if you have an opinion, then feel free to state so in the comments. You know, do you want me to cut the video after Act 2, or do you want me to keep playing until, you know, the maximum allotted time? Because, I mean, really, it doesn't matter to me. It's just whatever would be best for you. Alright, I'm Duke of the Bump. See you guys next time on Let's Play Sonic Megamix.